everybody. Welcome back to another exciting episode of the Coco and Dalt's podcast. I say another exciting episode every episode, but today is especially exciting because it's our 150th episode.
Ooh, cue the crazy music.
So I'm not Dalt.
And I'm not Coco.
And we are real people bringing you real reviews of all the latest streaming offerings on Apple TV+, Amazon Prime Video, Netflix, Disney+. Anything else I'm missing?
Home videos on the side of the garage.
That's correct. So what are we reviewing today, Dalt?
So this episode, not only is it special because it's 150, and we appreciate you, listener, for sticking around for 150 episodes.
Thank you, listener.
But also because this is about hockey.
And Dalt is Canadian.
And I'm a hockey guy. So therefore, this is right up my alley, to mix my metaphors. What we're doing here is called All or Nothing, Toronto Maple Leafs. It's a docuseries on Amazon Prime Video, and it's a many-faceted five episodes, I think.
We've done a lot of research, you can tell.
Yeah, well, you can tell that I don't do the summaries very often because I'm kind of bad at them. But so it's essentially following around the Toronto Maple Leafs during the pandemic-shortened and affected 2020 regular season and playoffs.
And what happened during the pandemic-affected 2020 regular season and playoffs for the Toronto Maple Leafs?
So, not much. they played hockey in front of nobody, and they had to deal with quarantine. They had to deal with pandemic restrictions in Toronto, where they were playing. The NHL ended up busting into two bubbles. One was in Edmonton and one was in Toronto. And of course, they were in Toronto. And they had to play all their games in one city so that they could keep the bubble together and not spread the coronavirus. That's how they got the hockey season going. And this was a tumultuous affair because it had highs and lows. So if you're a Toronto Maple Leafs fan, you know what I'm talking about, because there are a lot of high expectations and usually low results. So that's why I say highs and lows. I'm originally from Toronto. I've lived through a lot of that, so I know the pressure that is on these fellas. So it's essentially inside the team. They follow the team around. It's kind of like Ted Lasso, actually.
It's kind of like Hard Knocks.
It's kind of like Hard Knocks, but
HBO Max. We do HBO Max too.
It's kind of like Hard Knocks, but it's kind of like Ted Lasso, and it's kind of like Trailer Park Boys.
Ooh,
when you think about it, because it's a documentary and there's cameras following swearing guys around,
and
they're Canadian,
and the Leafs not winning the cup is the worst case Ontario.
Oh, wow. You're not seeing this, listener, but we're doing a fist bump right now.
We just blew it up.
So that's what this is about. Did I miss anything, really?
No, not really.
So they followed the team around during the course of the season. The season actually turned out to be very good subject matter because of the pandemic. We don't like the pandemic, but this turns into something good for the documentary. We follow around Kyle Dubas, who is the GM of the team. We follow around Sheldon Keefe, who is the coach of the team. We follow around a few of the players, Frederick Anderson, the goalie, Austin Matthews, superstar, a couple of the other guys, Mitch Marner, who's a local guy with high expectations and a lot of pressure on him, etc. John Tavares, who's also a local guy. He's the captain of the Toronto Maple Leafs, so you can imagine being in that position, the kind of pressure he faces. And then he suffers a horrific injury, and that's in the documentary. Overall, I thought it was pretty well done. I don't know if I would watch it again, but I'd like to find something similar on another team and watch it, because it was pretty good. It was not all the way in. Like, the Toronto Maple Leafs are the New York Yankees and the New England Patriots all wrapped into one in terms of secrecy and privacy and being a big, you know, big deal in their market and that sort of thing, and not really letting people inside to have a look at what's going on. But I thought it did a fairly good job of that. And now that I've spoken for 14 minutes in a row, Coco, what do you have to say?
So I agree. I enjoyed it. I used to work in sports journalism. I did that for 10 years and I got tired of it. So I no longer do that. And I actually really don't watch sports anymore. But watching the game action parts of the docuseries, I was like, wow, I could sit down and watch a hockey game again. Mm-hmm. Like, I remembered why I like the game. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. That was good. I agree, though, that You know, I understand the philosophy of not airing your dirty laundry in public when there are issues happening with the team and stuff, but it a lot of it felt and a lot of it felt surface level. Like, mm-hmm. if any conflicts bubbled up, they were just kind of very quickly dealt with and brushed to the side. Like, Coach Keefe didn't like something that Austin Matthews said in a post-game press conference, so he went and bitched Kyle Dubas about it, and Kyle Dubas was like, yeah, you got to talk to him, and so then it all got resolved in like 5 minutes, mm-hmm. and they were like, oh, okay, yeah, we're fine.
And they're all happy, joy after that.
Yeah, so I understand, like I said, not airing your dirty laundry in public because then you don't want things to snowball and now there's distractions and stuff. But at the same time, it's like any other workplace mm-hmm. situation. There are going to be people who don't get along. There mm-hmm. are going to be people who don't like each other, people who rub you the wrong way. Like, stuff pops up. So I wish we could have seen a little bit more of that and not just the happy gloss that got put on it. It kind of reminded me of the first season of the Disney Mandalorian docuseries. What was it called? Like the Disney Vault or something? Mm-hmm. And it was like a 6-episode docuseries. And it was just basically all the producers and directors just kissing each other's asses the whole time and saying, you're great. No, you're great. Right. And it's like, I know that's not how it really went in real life. So I wish we could have seen a little bit more of decisions and struggles. I did like when some of the real life stuff came through. That was really cute to see. Like, they brought in one hair guy who just basically had everybody on an assembly line and was just cutting everybody's hair because it's the pandemic and
they couldn't go out and get it done.
They couldn't go out to a salon and get it done. So they just brought one guy in and he just did everybody all at once. And that was like really funny. And he was just like, oh, you've got the worst hair. Like, who cut your hair? Do you have a Flowbee or whatever? And then apparently a lot of the guys are really into coffee. So they're having big discussions mm-hmm. about like buying grounds versus buying whole beans and grinding them yourselves. And can we get into the club? We've got to pay like $20 to like bring in our own coffee or something. So that was cute. But I enjoyed it. I thought there was just enough mix of on ice versus off ice. I do wish, speaking of on ice, we had seen a little bit more of, all right, we're playing the Habs and this is their first power play unit, like a little bit more X's and O's mm-hmm. type mm-hmm. stuff. I understand if you don't want to give that away, but when the season's over, what does it matter? So overall, I enjoyed it. But I still think Austin Matthews has a punchable face.
Yeah, so why is that?
He looks like
a punchable face, because I don't want to have that face.
He looks like every Midwestern good old boy D-bag like I've ever known. He's from Arizona, yeah. But he's got a punchable face.
All right. Well, he's a really good hockey player.
Yeah, but he
scores goals.
Yeah, he's a very good hockey player. Yeah. But
I overall I like this. I think this is a good entree if you don't know anything about the Leafs, because there was enough controversy in this to pique your interest. Like, oh, they dealt with that thing where the Russian kid wasn't playing very well, and you know, we got to see the conversation between the GM and the Russian kid, and that was actually insightful. So if you're sort of on the periphery on this kind of stuff, I thought it was fairly informative. But if you're somebody like me who knows what's going on with the Leafs and knows, you know, that there are a lot of internal struggles with sponsors and the GM and the president of the team happens to be Brendan Shanahan, who was a pretty formidable player in his day. That's a Blues fan talking right there. And
former Blues fan.
And there was a lot of depth to what goes on behind the scenes. And I think if you're interested in just like the surface and skimming off it, because we didn't really get deep into this kind of stuff. And, but that's okay for this kind of thing. It's going to be on Amazon Prime. People are going to go through, oh yeah, I like that series. Maybe I'll watch the hockey one. Mm-hmm. And you're going to watch the Leafs. That's pretty high profile. It's not like it's the Florida Panthers all or nothing, you know. You see these guys coming into
now
the rink.
That might really be an interesting one. Wow.
Coming into the rink with their flip-flops on and their golf clubs over their head, you know, shoulders, and like, oh yeah, we got a game today, okay.
Wow.
Like, totally.
Wow, adults.
Like one of those bad teams that don't really care all that much about what they're doing. But yes, yeah, so good. I thought it was good. I mean, I would have liked more, but mm-hmm. fairly good. It was only 5 episodes.
Yeah.
We got through it pretty fast. It took us a while to podcast about it, but we got through it.
Yeah. It didn't drag. It was very entertaining. They mm-hmm. were, I don't even think any one of the episodes was like a full hour, right?
No, just under an hour.
Yeah. Yeah. So
yeah,
I'd recommend. One thing I will also add is that I do wish at the end there had been just some cards saying,
right,
you know, oh, this guy that we picked up at the trade deadline, he's no longer with the team. He signed with the Bruins. Oh, this defenseman that we focused on a lot, he's no longer with the team. He went here. Oh, John Tavares is, you know, in negotiations because his 10-year deal is about to end or whatever. You know, right. So I wish there had been, like, the players and stuff that we had seen a lot. I wish there had been an update on what they're doing after that season, because I was like, oh, what happened to that guy that they picked up at the trade deadline? So I had to go to Google and Google that guy's name and
right.
find out that he's with the Bruins now.
Yeah. So. Yeah, I agree with that. There was a little bit of a drop off there at the end. There's like, oh, should there be more or should there be title cards at the end or what's happening? I agree. And the other thing I agree with is you're mentioning the players. It's sort of like what we were saying about Ted Lasso. I needed more player interaction, like the player interaction in the dressing room / locker room. There wasn't a lot of that, understandably so, but just a little bit of it would have been, a little bit more of it would have been good because hockey players give each other so much crap and they're so funny that I would have liked to have been inside on some of that stuff. Like poor Jack Campbell, the goaltender, who's like flake city, you know, goalies are flaky to begin with, but this guy's like way out there and he seems like he's genuinely a nice guy. And the teammates just love him. And there's a scene there where they're eliminated from the playoffs and he's crying and stuff like that. And they're consoling.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah. Well, people know the Leafs are getting eliminated from the playoffs. That's not a spoiler. But he's like a really interesting character. But it would have been interesting to see the back and forth, you know, of and the traditions. There's some things in the locker room like never step on the logo and stuff like that. There's some things that we weren't able to see because of the pandemic. You know, didn't have the media. The physical presence of the media in Toronto is pretty overwhelming. It just had guys going on Zoom, essentially Zoom press conferences. And that doesn't show the pressure because the Leaf dressing room can be just jammed with cameras. And, you know, there's probably 40 or 50 people in there at one time talking to one particular player. And we didn't really get a sense of that. So that was a bit of a ripoff, but that's on the pandemic. That's not really on the filmmakers. But overall, It was well done. It could have been better. What are you grading it out of 26 letters, Coco?
Well, before my grade, I also want to add Willie Nylander.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to Willie Nylander because he is naked all the friggin' time. Like
those Swedes, man.
Every time it's like between periods and it's intermission, they're back in the dressing room. He's got his entire kit off. He's just sitting there in his jock strap. And the first time I noticed that, I was like, oh, I wonder if like he got a bloody nose and got it all over his, you know, uni and now he's got to change. But then I started noticing, no, every time it's intermission and they're back in the dressing room, he is naked.
He's in his gitch.
Yeah. And nobody else, like they might have like their sweaters off or something, but everybody else is pretty much fully clothed. And he's just sitting there like sharpening his stick, not a euphemism, in his jock strap. So hats off to, you know, 25-year-olds who are confident and
this is what happens when you're a superstar and you're that young and you're brought up in a hockey household. His dad was a hockey player with the Blackhawks for many years.
And a film crew is around and you're like, yeah, ladies,
so this is what I got.
Yeah.
I think that you reminded me of one other thing that I think that was missing from this is that because players are so superstitious, they're quirky and superstitious. We didn't really get a sense of any of that in this show. Like hockey players are among the most superstitious players, pro athletes out there. And we didn't really get a sense of, you know, like they tape their stick this certain way, or they always, you know, take all their clothes off down to their skivvies, or, you know, they happen to have a banana sandwich in between periods, you know, like there's a lot of those kind of quirky things that some of the players do. And we didn't really get a sense of that. And that really kind of reveals the kind of player that they are too, because some of these guys are whacks, you know, like they're just, yeah, they're just way out there. Right. And in a good way. And we don't really get a sense of that. It's just like, oh, this guy's from Saskatchewan and this guy happens to be from Michigan, you know, like it's just, that doesn't really tell us a lot. So I think that was a bit of a miss, but overall 26 letters, Coco.
I give it a B. I give it a solid B.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you know what I'm going to give it?
7.
Yeah, it was a 7, I'd say. Maybe a 7.5, because I enjoyed the subject matter and I'm familiar with the team and everything like that. So a little bit more than 7, but yes.
Maybe a 67, because that's the last time they won the cup.
Or
was that the last time they won the cup?
Yeah, that was the last time. Oh, okay. Also the year I was born, so no coincidence whatsoever there.
And that was the expansion season too, right?
Look at you dropping the hockey knowledge.
See, listener, I said this is I used to be in sports journalism, so I know.
But you retained it.
I did.
You retained it.
That's true.
So anything else to offer up on All or Nothing Toronto Maple Leafs?
No, just give us more, Amazon.
Give us more. Yeah, that was pretty good. I liked it. All right. So for another episode of the podcast, we ripped through this one pretty good because we had nothing to offer.
I think we did a pretty good job. I think we did a pretty good
job. No, you know what happens? Whenever I do the summary, I'm just off. I'm just off for the rest of the podcast. So I think it throws my rhythm off. I just think you should do the summaries from now on.
Well, we figured that you would be good for the summary for this one, though, because it's hockey. And oh, yeah. You're a hockey fan.
Yeah, so. But I'm not good at summaries. So we need to.
You think that, but that's not true.
Well, listener, if you have an opinion, please weigh in.
That's right. Let us know. We are on Facebook and Twitter at Coco and Daltz, all one word. You can also email us at cocoanddaltz@gmail.com, or you can find us on the interwebs at cocoanddaltz.com.
So for another episode of the podcast, as I spit it out, I'm not Coco.
And I'm not Daltz.